Now, we won't even enter the next point of conversation we will talk, so we will discuss this morning, and about zoning arrangement and whether we fit use that one, whether that one fit work, whether it go fit produce the lead that we will define for Nigeria. We still get Oga Folari inside studio with us also. So we go like making just a touchlight for that one. Then we said we will still take your opinion, Oga Andy. So, Oga Folari, what do you feel? This zoning arrangement, if you say this one fit produce the leader we Nigeria need, or waiting the leader we will define. Since we don't talk, say the political party system, feel not change the matter. Now, zoning, what do you feel about that? Whether it will help us?
As it is now, zoning is very important. Why I thought it is very important? You know, say now, in this separatist agitation day, say, okay, some part of the country say they don't tire for this union. And the only way we feel maintain this unity. I should say, okay, this nation building, say we still day together. We say, make zone is still day. Because now, some part of the country, for 2015, they shall say, okay, make power go north then. They mobilize themselves. Yeah. They chase the Ikuben governor, president come up for office. Now, these same people now, all they thought say power, say make we no talk about zoning again now, say make we talk about competence. But the issue now be say, zoning no affect say we no go get effective leader. The two can go hand in hand. If you remember vividly, say the certain governors they met last year July for Lagos. In their communique with the issue, they thought say okay make they believe say power rotation supposed day, and power must return to south. So for us to preserve this unity, preserve this union, say make zoning day. And first of all, they talk something for that communique also. They talk say, make all political parties ensure say, may they feed certain candidates. As it did for 1999.
That was supposed to be a gentlemanly agreement. It's not as if it's legal.
Yeah, no, I'm not talking about legal.
But now, what thing will they try to stress on now? Now, whether this zoning go fit produce the right candidate will go fit take Nigeria to the promised land, because we're supposed to look zoning at this level, or we're supposed to look competence and who go fit deliver Nigeria.
Yeah,
that's what I said. So now, talking about zoning, if it's today within these people, the way they already they power, just want to make a shift on their side, it will still affect free candidacy too.
Yeah.
You know, from that level.
Yeah, somehow it will affect five, because, okay, if you talk, say, you won't get zoning, if you look at me, say, only zoning. Zoning alone is no guarantee say we'll get effective leaders. That should not be the only criteria. Say we will pick candidate for 2020 or we political party supposed to consider. So we'll look at capacity, effectiveness, say, this guy get this expertise. Which idea he gets for security? Which idea he get for economy? How he will create
governance.
Expand our economy, create more opportunities for our teaming youth. I think that those two supposed to go together, because you know if you jettison zoning now, because say you know the fragility of our union now. So for us to preserve, say ensure, say okay, this union is still there beyond 2023. Zoning supposed there, and it's supposed to go hand in hand with competence, capacity. Make political parties across board may they ensure say they give candidates we get this traits, options, make a electorate decide who they want.
There. Okay, so we get Mr. Andy Akpoti Vestide. Mr. Andy, if you're there with us, you don't hear what Mr. Folari talk. You feel say we need to bring all our cultural diversity to play in selecting a leader by ensuring say we give every group space, or we could just talk about the fact say Nigeria they dicey situation and they in their need of a credible leader irrespective of any zone where in from come.
So in medicine, they get what you would call signs and symptoms. When you present before the doctor in the consulting room, you get fever, you get headache. Those can be symptoms of malaria. You know, when the doctor don't see these symptoms, the doctor will come, in reaching the diagnosis, come send you go lab, may you go do some investigation, then you reach the diagnosis. I don't talk all these things to underscore the point, say, the very fact, say, Nigerians are still swimming in that very pedestrian conversation of zoning. Speaks to the fact that there's no unity in Nigeria.
That's right.
Speaks to the fact that there's still the mindset of it's our turn to thief and our turn to chop. Speaks to the fact that Nigerians are not ready to come out of medical waters. All these things you people call zoning, you call, what's that one again, catchment area, all those nonsense. You don't find them in civilized climes on society. You can find husband and wife ruling a country. What do I care who rules the country so long as I've got health care that is functional? What do I care who rules the country so long as I've got education that is functional? See, I also won't go on strike. Mm-hmm. What do I care who rules the country so long as I've got functional rules? Today, ministers of works, now then they drive on our roads, then they fly plane. Today, ministers of power, then they use generator for their houses. Today, ministers of health, then they travel abroad for their medical, including our president. Today, ministers of education, all their children, their family members, they are abroad. They're not in school for our educational system. And you tell me to come travel inside that very pedestrian water of zoning. Who cares who is in charge? Whether it's Urobo man, whether it's Shekiri man, whether it's Awusa, whether it's Fulani. What I'm interested in is that we should have a system that can only throw up the best. Go see what is working in China. Is China even a democracy? I was on radio a couple of days back, and I was arguing this. The system that works in China, is it a democracy? The rest of the world, we are going to borrow money from China. The system that works in Russia, is it a democracy? Who says we must follow after the standards that are created by us? What are we not thinking in Africa and in Nigeria? Are we ready to build something that is purpose-built for us, for our peculiarities, for our particularities? For our own conditions.
Okay.
Why are we going to bug?
All right, Oga Andy. So for you, zoning is not necessary. So now, wait till you talk. Say zoning no dey necessary according to your conversation so far, right? Oga Folan is still there here, and his own view be say we need zoning to at least move forward in this current situation with it. Oga Folari, you don't hear waiting Oga Andy talk.
Yeah.
Wait till you feel about this thing. Seeing the fact, say you support this motion of zoning.
Yeah, ideally, yeah, we should know they talk about zoning, but as they day now, you know the fragility of the country now. Mm. These issues where people ask questions, will they hear Yoruba Nation, will they hear IPOB, so they carry it. So just to assuage these people, say, okay, make we maintain the balance.
Is it for peace to reign?
Yeah, just for peace, because we need to have
equity.
Yeah, we need to have a country fair before we really talk any other thing.
Hmm.
So, Zoni.
Yoruba Nation and Biafra, they are symptoms of a failed country. All of these agitations you are seeing, they are symptoms of weak leadership, failed country, stupid system. Pardon my use of that word. Once you fix leadership, right leadership, Yoruba Nation will fizzle out. Biafra will fizzle out. All these Urobo agitation and Niger Delta, they will fizzle out. We are concentrating on the symptoms. We are not looking at the disease condition. The disease condition is what we should address. The patient is before us, and the patient is complaining about pain. And the patient is analgesic.
Judging from what Oga Folari is saying, this one they won't serve as first aid measure to service the situation, right?
To the theater.
But Mr. Andy, you try talk, make we not pay attention to the diversity for the country, to the fact say we actually feel get good leaders from any side of the country. You know, we the same could not pay attention to that. It no matter whether in 20 years now only people from the particular part of the country now in the rulers and everything they work well. It no matter.
You know, see Bill Clinton became president of America. After he finished, his wife was interested. The Democrats supported her.
Okay, now,
go everywhere you want.
If we want to look up now,
let me say, when they talk about tribal, where they come from, the state, to go around the world now, go see what is happening. Who is interested?
Mr. Andy Akpotiuegbu, you talk something about our peculiarity.
Becomes the president.
See,
who is interested in that?
Mr. Andy Akpotiuegbu,
make I tell Nigerians.
Mr. Andy, I want to say something. Mr. Andy Akpotiuegbu, before now you talk something about we should look inward into our peculiarity. Now, when we look into our system, our domain, the kind of country we come out from, you go see, I'm saying, right from day one, in our electoral system, in our leadership system, we did diverse. And sometimes a lot of us, they feel like, oh, when it comes to these people, una rally and una supporter, now look at the southeastern people. Not be about say, okay, leadership and all that. Why we not just say leaders we still come from there? You not think say sometimes some of these things, not be because we not know the Western standard. We know I'm bet the kind of country we live, so it not go they fair if everybody just like this zoning, a gentlemanly agreement when any group of people can just agree within themselves just for national peace to reign. So you fix anything bad with that kind of a gentlemanly agreement, even if it's not the legal. So that everybody will feel like we be part of the system.
Shouldn't I call a gentleman agreement? So if you do the gentleman agreement and I not agree, what thing will happen? For instance, now the North say they not agree. Now gentleman agreement you call it. Why they not put down for the constitution? They not put all those other nonsense in our constitution about catchment area. I forget the other one. They not put all those nonsense for our constitution. They put them.
All right, Mr. Andrew.
Federal character. All those nonsense. They don't put for our constitution. Federal character will even Buhari not the follow.
Mr. Andy, we don't get time again, so we would like hear your final word, just one word, you know, one sentence, final word on top of this matter.
My final word.
Moving forward.
Nigerians will wake up from sleep. The day Nigerians will stop being docile and apathetic. That day, the country will not start to be correct. The head of the country will not start to be correct. The reason why leadership, they do all this nonsense they are doing, because we are not serious yet. The day we are serious, we'll drive them.
All right, Folari, we'll like to hear your parting shots for inside this matter.
I think for me, my parting shots say, for the sake of reconciliation, and for the sake of say, make we preserve this union, zoning, suppose, make we uphold the principle of zoning. And not just zoning with competence. Make political parties, make they start a shop for candidates, we get capacity, we get bright ideas, we feel move our country. So, no be jettisoning zoning now, fine. We suppose know the third zoning now, but for the mere sake, say our union is fragile. And is it now the only symptoms we feel preserve this nation be that zoning. And zoning should go hand in hand with them. Capacity, competence. So the responsibility are they give political parties within Nigeria now, say, maybe they start a shop for credible Nigerians, we get bright ideas. So I made a zone this thing to southern part. I not just say southern part, southeast, because we could give them a sense of belonging. Thank you very much.
All right, thank you so much. Well, you don't hear waiting, Mr. Andy Akpotive talk. In the social reformer, and of course, we don't also hear with Mr. Andy. Thank you very much as you joined us, and Mr. Folari Opeyemi Joseph, the public affairs analyst. The two of them don't put smart talk for this matter. First of all, we start with the third force, and then we can't enter inside this issue of zoning. How you take it? And we don't hear their belay, you know, waiting to talk at the end of the day. Well, the good morning I just will never finish. But she don't have that for corner to tell us how everything you share concerning sports for inside this weekend. Stay with us. When they come back.